Having given me the opportunity to partake in the discussion pertaining to the allocations made for the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Sir, initially I would like to congratulate Srimati Nirmala Sitharamanji for having presented her 7th consecutive budget in the House. And also I would like to congratulate Sri Naddaji, who has very ingenuously made the allocations for the various departments in his own ministry, keeping in mind the challenges that the country is facing today pertaining to the health sector. Sir, even as India is making great strides in terms of GDP, where the world GDP is about 3% and the GDP of India is estimated to be anywhere between 7.2 to 8%, India is in a state of economical and demographical transition today. And keeping this in mind, I think when it comes to the health sector, there is a lot more space for us to actually maneuver and to move around. Sir, to achieve the set targets in our country when it comes to health, I think the infrastructure in our country also needs to ramp itself up. And the health infrastructure has been stretched and it needs to be strengthened further. Having said that, sir, against this background, the very thought to establish wellness centers, because if we have to take into consideration the health concerns of the country at the tertiary level, I think our roots will also have to be very strong. And going by what is said earlier by our ancestors, that prevention is better than cure, the setting up of wellness centers at the ground level, I think, is a very welcome measure, wherein the primary health screening is done, and then probably, if so required, they would be sent to for tertiary care to district and other higher hospitals. Sir, even as I appreciate and welcome the setting up of the wellness centers, which are the Arogya Kendras at the grassroots level, I think we would also have to introspect on the condition and situation of our CHCs and PHCs. So today they are literally starved of infrastructure at the CHCs and PHCs, where we do not have the required number of doctors in place or paramedics in place. And I'm sure all of us have been seeing time and again in media, where even power or electricity has been cut to these CHCs and PHCs, and in the light of the torches, there have been surgeries that have been done too. So I think that we need to kind of work with the state governments as well to ensure that these the infrastructure at the CHCs and PHCs are strengthened. I have been listening with rapt attention to my colleagues on the other side of the benches, who have repetitively been speaking about the 2.5% of the GDP that needs to be allocated for health, and the central government not doing enough when it comes to allocation. So may I remind them that the 2.5% of the GDP that needs to be allocated for health is not necessarily the central government alone, but the states would also have to be proactive and forthcoming to put in their allocations. And we see largely that the states are not so forthcoming when it comes to their priorities when it comes to the health, sir. And sir, I have also been listening to my friends on the other side when they're repetitively talking about out-of-pocket expenditure, which is large in our country. But we also have to appreciate, sir, the work done by the interventions done by the central government by setting up not only the wellness centers which help in screening of the patients, but also in setting up the Jan Aushadhi Kendras, because largely the patients have to spend large amounts of money, and the burden on the people of India is largely when it comes to medicines. So the Jan Aushadhi Kendras actually help in reduction of expenditure to the patients, and also the Ayushman Bharat, which actually provides insurance coverage for 50 crore population in our country. So even as I speak about the Ayushman Bharat, I would definitely have to talk about my state of Andhra Pradesh, where there was a scheme that was run in the name of Arogya Shri, and the then Chief Minister, Sri Jagan Mohan Reddy, he applauded himself and said that he was expanding the Ayushman Bharat by, because Ayushman Bharat covered only about 1,000 and odd health initiatives, whereas his own scheme covered large more, close to about 2,000 plus. But in the whole scheme of things, he not having paid the private hospitals who were actually shouldering the Ayushman Bharat and the Arogya Shri, today have refused to come forward and support the Ayushman Bharat and the Arogya Shri. And this is negatively impacting the Ayushman Bharat scheme in our own state. So I would request the Honorable Minister, even as she is seated here, to kindly take note of this and to ensure that the difficulties that our state is facing is overcome. Sir, having said that, the skilled workforce in our country is also a problem. Like, for example, physicians. We have just about 7 physicians for about 10,000 population in our country, whereas the requirement is largely more. So keeping that in mind, the intent to actually increase the number of colleges and to connect them to the government hospitals is very welcome. But however, sir, we need to keep in mind that even as we increase the number of colleges, the required number of teaching staff is also going to be an issue for us. And in our attempt, or in all the good intent that the central government has to improve the workforce, I think we need to keep in mind the quality also. As I had mentioned, there is a shortage of teaching staff already in the medical colleges, and how do we fill this gap is going to be an area of concern for us. Sir, I have been listening to my colleagues when they have been saying that very little has been allocated for mental health. Sir, there has been an increase from 63 crores to 90 crores when it comes to mental health. I do agree, sir, given into the fact that there's a lot of psychological pressure on our children when it comes to neutral families, the after effects of COVID, and also, if I may say, the drug addiction that we see in the country. I think this increase in allocation is welcome, though we desire that a lot more should be done in this direction. Sir, Digital UWIN is a wonderful intervention, sir, where people largely who are migrating, we have a lot of migrant force, and when they are migrating, they do not have to carry their physical records, but they have it all stored in a digital portal, and wherever they go, for them to access them would be very easy, and the medical records are safe. And this is assuring the entire country that it is also kept confidential. So the Digital UWIN is really welcome. Sir, the increase of 4% for research is very, very important in our country today, because we see an increase of non-communicable diseases. And even as I speak, we are also hearing of new diseases that are coming in the form of Nipah and so on and so forth. And therefore, we need to really increase our allocations for research to ensure that we are able and capable to face such challenges that come up. Needless to say, the other interventions in the medical sector as well. And therefore, sir, the increase in allocation for research is really welcome, sir. Sir, having said that, we need to also look at the interim budget, the provisions in the interim budget, even as we look at the provisions in the budget itself. Sir, in the interim budget, there has been mention that Ayushman Bharat would today be extended to Anganwadi workers, ASHA workers, and other workers at the Anganwadis, and also senior citizens who are 70 plus. Sir, today we have, even as we talk of our demographic dividend, we have longevity that has increased in our country. And where we were talking about 62, 65 years, today we are talking about 72 to 75 years of longevity. So keeping that in mind, sir, geriatrics has been a very, very neglected section when it comes to the health sector. So keeping that in mind, sir, I think extending the Ayushman Bharat cards to 70 plus senior citizens is rather very welcome, and would support them even in their even at the older ages. Sir, I was also listening to many of my colleagues who were talking about about setting up of tertiary hospitals like AIIMS, where the number of AIIMS have increased, but the speed at which the construction should happen has not been happening. Sir, but we need to also keep in mind that state governments, as their share, would have to give in the provide the infrastructure, wherein largely when it comes to our own AIIMS in Mangalagiri in Andhra Pradesh, there had been an inordinate delay in construction of AIIMS because the state government would not remove the high tension wires from this site or remove the electrical things that were existing there. So there was an inordinate delay. Besides that, 10 crores of rupees was all that we were looking for from the state government to provide drinking water and water facility to AIIMS. But even that was denied for a long, long time, which actually delayed the construction of AIIMS. Therefore, state governments, sir, would have to be very forthcoming when the central government is all willing to go out and do everything to improve the health infrastructure in our country. I think even the state governments would have to come forward, sir. Sir, as I was talking about the digital mission, the ABDM, sir, which was launched in 2021 as part of Ayushman Bharat digital mission, we need to keep in mind that the health records, sir, have been today are 39.77 crores that have been linked with Aadhaar cards. When you link them with Aadhaar cards, sir, as I had spoken about UWIN, it makes it very, very easy for them when they travel with their Aadhaar cards to access their records which are digitally saved, sir. And, sir, the Jan Aushadhi Kendras, sir, as I had mentioned earlier, the Jan Aushadhi Kendras today, they provide medicines at a much cheaper rate, almost 50 to 90% cheaper than what they are available, or lesser in rate as to what they are available in the markets. And just recently, the 10,000 Jan Aushadhi Kendra was actually inaugurated, sir, at AIIMS in Devgarh last year. Sir, even as I speak of Jan Aushadhi Kendras...
Kindly conclude, madam.
Yes, sir. Even as I talk about Jan Aushadhi Kendras, we also need to keep in mind the fact that today India is called the pharmacy of the world. And we not only are producing our own medicines, but are in a situation where we are able to supply to the entire world. But sir, I think I would like to draw the attention of the minister to the fact that we need to invest in API manufacturing. We are solely dependent today on China, sir. And once we are successful in manufacturing our own APIs, I think medicines would be much more available. Sir, coming to the last point, the cancer that many of us are quite concerned about. Sir, Global Observatory had said that India stands third after China and USA when it comes to the incidences of cancer in our country. Therefore, the three medications which the BCD or basic customs duty has been reduced on is a welcome measure which will actually make cancer treatment available to people who are in deeply need of it. And also the X-ray tubes and the flat screens, the BCD being reduced on it, would actually make medical care and attention easily accessible to people who actually need it, sir. Sir, I only like to conclude by saying that even as the central government provides for the healthcare in the country, it is up to the states to also come forward proactively and avail the support that the central government is coming. So even as the central government comes up with a health policy, it would be ideal if state governments could come up with a health policy of their own, keeping their own issues of the state in mind, so that they can come up with innovative interventions to ensure that health is made available and reachable to all. Thank you, sir.